Hello. I did not see you there. This is part two of the three-part series for Dr. Pointer's lecture class. And we're here today at Pearl Harbor, one of the most historic places in American history. Now, throughout this video, you may see these weird earphone things on my head. This is what I call an audio tour. And I may at times copy and paste every word that is said on the audio tour for factual information. And there's the headquarters for the commander of the U.S. Pacific Fleet. Here's my question. Why isn't he on a boat? Well, of course, the wet floor. It's the ocean. Now, we just finished at Pearl Harbor, and besides Pearl Harbor, there are lots of other cool things to see. For instance, this is the submarine museum for the USS Bowfin, which we'll see in just a minute. And, you know, it's a museum history of many types of submarines and submarines and that sort of thing. So here's an example of a submarine right here. As you can see, it's very well done and everything. There's a torpedo hanging out the back. But some submarines didn't have so much success because they would only be finished on one side, like this one here. As you can see, this was clearly unfinished, and the second they put it into the water, it sank. So they started making them finished on both sides. Now, here is an example of a sundial that they would use on these submarines, and they worked very well until the submarine submerged under the water, and that was when they decided that there was a need for non-sundial clocks in submarines. Now here's an example of the first nuclear submarine called the USS Nautilus. Now it worked very well, except the submarine was very, very small, as you can see, and they couldn't fit the uranium atoms, as you can see right there, into such a small submarine. So it sank, just like the others. Here's an example of a torpedo launch tube area, and this is where you could walk in, and you could walk up straight to those torpedoes, and you could just launch them however you wanted to. Very crucial in winning World War II. Back on the deck of the USS Bowfin, the submarine that was the revenge for the Pearl Harbor. And as you can see, the submarines would have long, elongated decks back here.
on which the sailors could bowl when the submarine submerged. It was extremely helpful. Timing is pretty sporadic, and the subject matter is all over the place, and I can explain that. You see, I've been walking for 10 hours around Pearl Harbor and Ford Island and the USS Missouri, and I'm exhausted, and I need to go throw up right now. So I apologize for any inconsistencies in this film. All right, this brings us to the end of the Pearl Harbor / World War II guest video thing. Hope you've enjoyed it. The end.